5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Second, cross, turn.
I'm a Chiquetti teacher, and Chiquetti is French and Italian, so all of my classes are taught in French.
Changement, 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 relevé.
I don't say bend your knees to the little kids. I'll say plié. Now when we plié, we're gonna bend our knees, so I add the two together. It's very detailed. You've got three primer levels, A, B, and C, and then you've got the older levels, grades 1 through 4, and then you've got the intermediate and advanced levels where the kids keep progressing up.
To be able to be in a small community, and especially one as rural and as far north as Rosseau, and have these opportunities for our kids to be part of something this spectacular, it's beyond my expectations.
My husband, we were in Illinois, and he was an electrical engineer at Bridgestone Firestone, and I like to cross-country ski. And so I said, honey, you got to get me someplace where there's snow and cold, because I need my seasons. So we ended up here.
Turn, turn, and chasse.
Kids are really into instant gratification. They want everything now. And dance is about working for it and mastering it and getting the technique down.
Lift.
It's not as easy as it looks. You gotta take training and you gotta be able to do the right foot positions and stuff.
The ballet gives you your foundation for everything that you have to learn how to do. That's where your pirouettes come from, that's where your leaps come from, that's where your extension of your leg and your toe and your knee turn out and your hip turn out. That's where everything starts from. I have a list every fall that starts out with what steps I want the kids to accomplish, and I check them off as we get to them. Everything progresses. The older they get, the more technical it gets. So it's all these little details that add up to getting a better dancer.
It teaches character. It teaches discipline. But also, through all that, you can see that through all the hard work, you can have the fun that comes out when you perform real well afterwards.
When you get on the stage and you actually do what you're told, and then at the end they clap for you, it makes yourself feel good.
When they get it, the smile on their face, that's what it's all about. When they beam and you give them a thumbs up that they got the step, that's better than anything.
I suggest you do a nice little board arabesque.
I didn't have the body type. I knew that wasn't an option, and I knew I wanted to teach dance. I wanted to be able to bring better things to my dancers. I like to be behind the scenes and creating it for everybody else to see. That's a joy.
Stomp, brush, hop, shuffle, step, full, lap, step, stomp.
I kind of dissect the songs in counts of 8, and then I pick the class that I'm going to go to, and I consolidate all the steps that they already currently know that they have a stockpile of, and then I pick steps that they haven't learned yet to add in there to keep it fresh for them.
Up, second, up.
There's a lot of little tiny details you have to remember. Before recital time, I sometimes get like, what am I doing? Because I get so nervous and it gets crazy, but it's always worth it.
Okay. All the movements have counts, so they know they have to get to a certain place at a certain time. And I make them count out the steps when we're doing it, but some of it is innate. Some of them, they have the extra little grace that they do the movements with. Grace is kind of an individual basis, because you can have a very technical dancer and you can have a very graceful dancer, and it's a joy when you get both of them together.
Having two children in dance that dance at different times, there's a time commitment, there's also the financial part of it, but I think it's worth every penny we pay for it.
You know who's going to want to be in dance class by the amount of hard work that they're putting in. If a child wants to do a solo, they'll be out in front. And they'll put themselves out in front. The child that does not want to do a solo or does not want to be in the front row will put themselves somewhere else.
First, we're just going to get our places.
I'm not going to make a better dancer by forcing them to do something that they're uncomfortable doing. And if I've got a child who will dance their heart out in the second row, I will let them dance their heart out, because that's going to give me a better class. And it's going to give me a stronger performance if they're dancing where they feel safe at. I'm teaching it, but they have to do the steps, and so they're in control of everything. They're thinking about what they're doing, they're executing it, and that's quite an accomplishment.
It helps with footwork and with sports and stuff. I'm in four sports, so just helps out, and it's fun.
Get in your row.
I don't think any dance teacher is a pushover. You can't teach kids without being assertive, because otherwise they'd run right over you. I mean, I had 19 teenagers up on stage during that group ballet number. They all need to be doing the same thing, so you need to get everybody where they're supposed to be doing, and they need to respect you, that you're gonna get them to where they need to be.
I don't know if I would be a professional dancer, but I definitely want to continue dancing in some way.
Hopefully, a couple will go on. Some of them, I'm glad to have taught them and given that appreciation so that they will introduce it to their children.
This program is funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.